Hey, what's up? I'm Chris Ellinas and welcome to Fasting 5, where I share fast-paced tutorials, tips and tricks around design in 5 minutes or less. Today's episode is one that I wasn't planning to do. Normally I wanted to upload my second vlog, but because I didn't have the time to finish the editing, and because I want to upload a video and today is the premiere of Avengers Endgame, I thought that would be a cool idea to make a special episode. For those that you don't know me, I'm a really big fan of Marvel comics and movies, and I have pre-ordered my tickets about a month ago. So today I want to show you how to recreate the Marvel intro that they used from 2008 until 2012, I believe. Now they use a more complex 3D one, but I prefer the previous one because it has that cool comic book effect. But if you want me to do the more complex 3D one and maybe experiment with a 3D software, let me know in the comments. Also in the description you will find a link with all the elements that I use so you can follow along. The first step will be to find the images you want to use and resize them so they all have the same size with your composition. For me it's 90-20 by 10-80. Bring them all in your composition and don't be overwhelmed if you have a lot of images, because we're going to work on them all at once, so it's going to be really easy. Highlight all of them and hit P for position. Then hit page down 3 times to move on the 3rd frame and set a stopwatch. In the beginning of your timeline, move them up so they are off screen. Easy is the last keyframes by clicking F9 and trim the layers. Select them all from the last one to the first one, right click on those layers and go keyframe assistant, sequence layers. With all of them selected, grab the endpoint of one of them and extend it a few frames so you don't have blank spaces anymore. If you like, you can add a texture on the top of your layers. If you do, remember to change the blending mode to multiply. Trim your composition by clicking N. Then activate the motion blur for your layers and composition. Let's create a second composition. Here you can have text or a logo or anything you like. And for the background, you need one color and maybe a black vignetting. It doesn't matter if you do that directly in After Effects or in Photoshop, just remember to have two separate layers. Bring the comic book composition underneath your logo. For me, the comic book composition stops around the 5th second. This will depend on the number of images you have used. Press Ctrl D to duplicate it and move the second one to the right. Select both of them, right click, pre-compose. Then change the blending mode to multiply. Press T at the keyframe for the opacity. Go further in your timeline and change the opacity to 0%. Right click on your logo, choose pre-compose, and remember to have the move all attribute selected. Apply the gradient wipe effect on your logo. Go to a different position in your timeline. For me it's around the 3rd second. Change the transition completion to 100% and the transition softness to around 20. The gradient layer should be the comic book layer. Add a keyframe to the transition completion, then further in your timeline, change it to 0%. Select the logo and comic book layer and press Ctrl D to duplicate them. Bring them on top. Change the blending mode of the comic book layer back to normal and move it a little bit to the left on your timeline, so the timing will be slightly different. Also change the track matte to alpha matte. Now move the other logo layer on top, press U, and move the first keyframe of the gradient wipe effect further to the right to have a shorter animation. Make all the layers 3D except of the background. Select the two logo layers and press P. Change the last value to negative 500 to create some depth, and then press S and change the scale to around 60%. Now go to the last frame and create a new camera. Add a keyframe on position and Z rotation. Go to the start of your timeline and change the Z rotation to around 30 degrees. And also change the last value of position to cover up the entire screen. Also move the last keyframe of the Z rotation to the left on your timeline so the rotation stops earlier. Finally, select all the keyframes of your layers and easy ease them by clicking F9. Add the page sound effect, epic music, and your intro is ready. A Remember not to limit yourself. You can change the number, values, colors and images to create a completely different result. Understand how the Marvel intro works and then use those steps to create something different. You could have images from your projects, for example, change the movement or the color to match your branding, and by changing the music you have a completely different vibe. So this was the special episode, I hope that you liked it. The second vlog is coming up really soon, and if you don't want to miss it, consider to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Right now I need to edit this video really fast so I can go to the movie, and if you're going too, let me know in the comments below. Until next time, Excelsior!